No storage of the biometric Aadhaar information on the client device. Because that is the concern where common perception is that, okay, I have given my bioprint to, bioimpressions to somebody X, Y, and Z. And he or she store it locally and then misuse it at a point of time. So to avoid that kind of a situation, number one, technologically, and also to remove the perceptual problem and put everyone at a comfort level, you know, this next level of evolution of Aadhaar has been designed. So there's a level zero so that there's no disruption of what's going on. Only you have download and then do that. And level one is where really, again, state of the art in terms of its security. So this is the stage and manner in which we are proceeding. And definitely we'll bring more guidelines so that it's clearer to the ultimate users. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions?
Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
We'll My name is Rohit. I represent Angel Broking. We are currently an AUA and a KUA, and we are using your services for our eKYC. It's a very good support that you've given us. We'd like to thank you. We just have one suggestion. We would like a forum where we could meet because many times our window into UIDAI is only either through e-mudra or today we are integrating with NSDL. So if we have a forum, when we have problems, we can discuss this, suggestions can come out, and we can also build a better relationship. That's my suggestion, sir.
Yeah, I think it's an excellent suggestion because the actual operations are done by the CEO, so I would not be kind of attending in these day-to-day matters. But from your intervention, it is clear that such interactions have not been happening frequently or any time at all. Definitely, since it is an open ecosystem and it's an ecosystem approach, it's not that government does and others take. That's not the case here in Aadhaar. The philosophy itself is ecosystem-based, and ecosystem has been, in fact, built. But a better dialogue between UIDAI as well as the ecosystem players will be really very much in order, and I'll immediately put it to my board. And, of course, today we are talking of, even globally also, co-design and co-creation. So that being the case where, it's a question of mutual dialogue and then going forward, it is in fitness of things. I think your observation is absolutely well taken. Thank you.
Go ahead, sir.
Good morning, sir. I'm Libin Johnson from Geetham University. I just wanted to check up, what are the government's plans in terms of using blockchain distributed technology as part of e-Pragati or other initiatives? Thank you.
Yeah, I think there would have been a session separately on this, but let me very briefly respond to your query. Blockchain definitely is a technology which has space, because government is, it has so many wide spectrum of activities which call for different kinds of technologies to be most useful there. So, blockchain definitely has is figuring high on our list of new technologies that we have to start embracing. And one area we are exploring, because it's a relatively new and the successful implementation, large-scale implementations of the kind that government requires are few, as we see. So we are going to try it out in the land regime. One of the 72 projects which you would have been shown the big screen yesterday, big picture, one of which is called the Land Hub, which deals with the land, entire thing related to land, that is the, any parcel of land or property situated on that land. We have several players who handle that information. So we are creating this land hub as a super layer over all these. For instance, there is a municipal authority which has a property tax on the property and ownership records. There is a revenue department which handles the titles to the land. Then there is a registration department which, when a transaction takes place, a sale takes place from on the property, you know, they register the deed. And there is a fourth department which does the, you know, survey and measurement of the land. So with so many departments, there is no single piece of, land-related information which is complete in itself and up-to-date by all means. So the land hub, the philosophy of land hub is to create that layer of single truth, single source of truth on land. Anything and everything about core data on land will reside in this land hub layer. Currently, as I talk, we have completed the schema and the design and the architecture for the landscape, land hub program layer, and the National Informatics Center is going to implement it in the next 3 to 4 months. So what we are thinking in that context, because these transactions especially, A sells to B, B sells to C, C sells to Z. So there is a chain of trust that needs to be established about, and I'm especially saying that this land hub is going to be a single source of truth. So this is coming very close to the concept of the, you know, blockchain, the philosophy behind and the architecture behind blockchain. So what we intend to do, and the Honorable Chief Minister was very quick to uptake this, that we will implement it in one particular jurisdiction at first and try it out. How the land registration regime can be put to use the blockchain technology. So we will be exploring other avenues as such, but the one that currently we think best fit is the land registration regime. So we're going to, as part of this land hub, which is already afoot, in terms of implementation, a portion, we'll not expose the whole state at one time with a new technology, as you know. We are dealing with very, very valuable properties and public rights and so on. So one geography we'll select, and in that we'll take up the blockchain to begin with. Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Satyanarayana. I think we have run out of time. Thank you very much for your time. All the best with your work at UADI.
Thank you, and all the best for the conference. I hope that Vizag really will vibrate with the FinTech mantra in the months to come.
It most certainly will, sir. Thank you.